28. Word meaning Kachit, one of the gopis, Madhukaram, a honey bee, Drushtva, seeing, Dhyayanti, while meditating, Krishna Sangamam, on her association with Krishna, Priya, by her beloved, Prasthapitam, sent, Dutam, a messenger, Kalpaitva, imagining it, Idam, the following, Abravit, spoke, translation. And purport by the followers of His Divine Grace. Translation. One of the gopis, while meditating on her previous association with Krishna, saw a honey bee. Saw a honey bee before her, and imagined it to be a messenger sent by her beloved. Thus she spoke as follows. Purport. Srimati Radharani is referred to in this verse as Kachit, a certain gopi. To establish that this particular gopi is in fact Srimati Radharani, Srila Jiva Goswami quotes the following verses from the Agni Purana. Gopyaha पप्रचुर उषाशी कृष्णानुचरम उद्धवम हरिलीला विहारंश तत्रकाम राधिकाम बिना राधा तद्भाव समलीना वासनाया विरामिता सखिभीर सभ्यधा शुद्धः विज्ञान गुणजिम्भृतम् इज्यन्ते वासिनां वेद सारमीषा विभावने. At dawn, the gopis inquired from Krishna's servant Uddhava about the Lord's pastimes and reaction. Only Srimati Radharani, immersed in thought of Krishna, withdraw her interest in the talks. Then Radha, who is worshipped by the residents of her Vrindavan village, spoke up in the midst of her girlfriends. Her words were full of pure transcendental knowledge and expressed the ultimate portion of the Vedas. In the Bhagavad Gita 15.15, Lord Krishna states, Vedesya sarveir ahameva vidyaha. By all the Vedas, I am to be known. To know Krishna is to love Krishna. And thus Radharani, by her own example and words, revealed her supreme love for the Lord. Having quoted the above verses from the Agni Purana, Srila Jiva Goswami also quotes the following from the Narasimha Tapani Upanishad, Purbakhanda. Yam sarve deva namanti mukhyo brahmavadinas cha, all the demigods and all the transcendental philosophers who desire liberation, bow down to the Supreme Lord. We should follow sweet. Om Ajnanam Timirandhasya Jnanam Janashalakaya Chakhyurunmilitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manohishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamaiham Dadati Swapadantikam Bande Aham Sri Guru Sri Jutapadakamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavansa Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahaganam Raghunatham Nitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakhanitamsa Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Desatarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gauravakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare Hare. So this person in Bhagavatam is called Bhramar Gitam. Actually Uddhava Sandesh is 46 and 47. And Uddhava has done his part. Now the gopis has also they have done their part. Now finally Kachit Sri Radharani, she is going to speak. So she spoke only 10 verses from text number 11 to text number 21. Total 11 verses, out of this 11, 10, from 12 to 21, sorry, these 10 verses, 12 to 21, these verses were totally spoken by Srimati Radhika. In her Dibya Unmada Sthiti, in her transcendental, pure love and affection state, she spoke. The acharyas, they considered these 10 verses as jalpa vakya, varieties of jalpa, that's why it's called chitra jalpa. There are 10 varieties of chitra jalpa, all these 10 verses are one variety. So in this text, Radharani is not started speaking, but Sukadeva Goswami is speaking. Krishna is hearing. How Krishna is not there? It is in Vrindavan. And Krishna is in Mathura. Krishna sent his messenger, Uddhava. So Uddhava came bearing a letter from Krishna's handwritten letter. That is Madhu. From Madhusudan, that Madhu, his own handwriting letter, brought to deliver here. So that's why Kachit Gopi, so she, Kachit, Jiva Goswami gave proof that that Kachit is none other than Srimati Radhika. Other sir says, definitely she is Radhika. Why? Now, whose name is difficult to utter by Sri Sukadeva Goswami, even Krishna want to keep secret, top secret. Radharani's name, top secret. Because she is that personality. When Krishna was performing Rasa dance in Vrindavan, in Jamuna Pulin, crores and crores of gopis were around him and trying their best to please Krishna. When Radharani saw this sadharana bhav, it is general. He is dealing with others and same with me. So she got maan. This maan is a part of prema. We know that rati, prema, then maan, pranaya, kopa, raga, anuraga, then bhava, then mahabhava. Radharani is mahabhava swarupani. In that stage. In Mahabhava also there are variety. Rudha Mahabhava and Adhirudha Mahabhava. All other Brajagopikas, they are to the extent of Rudha Mahabhava. This Rudha Mahabhava, it cannot happen, it cannot exist in any other living entity except Brajagopikas. But Adhirudha Mahabhava is the only in Srimati Radhika, not even Brajagopikas. So in that stage, that's why she has only that potency, that power to think of dhyayanti Krishna Sangamam, not dhyayanti about Krishna. Krishna dhyana, no. Krishna Sangama dhyana, Krishna Samagama dhyana. Only her potency, dhyayanti Krishna. Kachit Krishna, when Radharani saw that sadharana behavior of Krishna, this is common behavior, so she went away. Immediately, the millions of gopis trying their best to please Krishna, but Krishna immediately felt no. And she left. He left. Krishna started searching for her. So, and only for Radhika, Krishna's Anandadayini Shakti is called Hadini Shakti, from by which he used to get Ananda and through which he used to give Ananda to others also, to his devotees and others. That is the only power, Hadini Shakti. And this Hadini, if take the essence of that Hadini, that is called Prema. And again you put in fire and make it essence, gadha, prema, then the essence of prema will become bhava. And again you make, bring essence from it, called mahabhava. Then Radharani is in mahabhava stage. So, for her, Krishna has such a high respect, that he doesn't want to speak out her name. Even Sukadeva Goswami, he knows Krishna's mood, he wants to keep it secret. Kachit, the word of Kachit is many significances are there. Ka, we know ka means water, ka means Brahma, ka means Srishti, ka means Sukha, ka means Brahma, ka means Param Brahma. Come in the purport of Vedic knowledge, and ka is sukha, ka is kanta, ka is Krishna. Ka chit, who knows only Krishna, nothing else. Who only think of Krishna, nothing else. And who select for sukha, for having any kind of pleasure, who select only Krishna, none else. And also similarly Krishna, if he want to be happy, he want pleasure, then none else than her. So that's why both of them are kachit, particularly for Krishna. She is kachit. Madgata chitta, madgata prana. Chitta, chitti matlab chitta, kachit, Krishna chitta. Whose man, buddhi, ahanka, antakaran is totally in Krishna. Krishna mayi, Krishna jara bhitare bahire. He sees Krishna inside He sees Krishna outside. Wherever she sees, she sees Krishna only. She thinks of Krishna only, speak of Krishna only. Whatever dealings her senses they are trying to do, only connected with Krishna, nothing else. That's itself kachit. Among the gopis, that gopi who is called kachit, which chitta not even a fragment, not even a fraction of second, think of anything else except Krishna, is a kachit gopi. See, drushtva madhukaram. She saw, because she was there among the gopis, they are talking to Uddhava, the messenger from Krishna. He wants to deliver the letter. And he was hearing the talking. Gopikas and Uddhava, they were talking, each other, they were hearing. And he was totally, this useless talk. That's why Radharani is saying madhukara. Madhu means sweet honey. Kara means hand. Well, this sweet natural honey in your hand only, taste it. Put it in your mouth. Some sweetness should come from your mouth, na? Only you are bearing the letter in your hand, that is madhu. But speaking only katu. What are you speaking? Because Krishna's own handwriting is his hand as madhukara. Only holding the madhu in her hand, not tasting it, not putting it inside. So whatever is coming out from your mouth, it's not madhu, it's katu. Only holding the madhu in your hand, madhukara. Actually, drushtva madhukaram, when Radharani was trying to speak up something among them, towards that madhukar, that messenger, Uddhava, at that time Krishna was fully in meditating what is going on in Vrindavan. And he appeared in the form of a bumblebee. He appeared actually. Why he appeared? Now he was very, very, very much interested to hear that abusing words from Radharani. प्रिया जदि मान करी करई भर्सन इस भर्सना प्रिया आउट ऑफ हिज मान बिकेम एंग्री एंड ही स्पीक अब्यूजिंग वर्ड्स कृष्ण एक्सेप्टेड सो प्लीजर वेद स्तुति हया तारे हरे मोर मन फार फार प्लीजर एंड बेटर देन वैदिक स्तुति दैट इज भर्सना ऑफ प्रिया. And Radharani and the Braj Gopisas, they have Samartharati. They are the only Samartharati. Samartharati means that attraction, that kind of dealings, loving dealings, that Rati, which is Krishna Basiyatva, mesmerized Krishna. That power, Krishna Basikarana Rati is called Rati. That is Samarthar. They are so powerful, they are so eligible to bring Krishna under them. That is Samarthar. And that is Brajagopikas, Brajasundaris, they have Samartharati, but Radharani is Parama Samartha. It's beyond them. Her power is beyond them. See, Radharani speaking, is going to speak now. So, because Dhyayanti, why Radharani was not speaking till now? Because she was totally in her meditation. What meditation? Dhyayanti Krishna Sangamam. Her very close association with Krishna. She was meditating on her close association with Krishna. It may be because Krishna is in Mathura now. So it may be in her dream, Krishna came in night. It may be meditating the previous past times, when they are meeting together personally, or it may be she is thinking that Krishna is now in Mathura city. The city girls, they are more beautiful, more smart, they are modernized in all sorts of matter. They have smartphone, computer, everything. They are expert in giving pleasure in so many ways. So Radhika is thinking of Krishna Sangamam, that she, Mathura Nagari, that city girls of Mathura and Krishna, how they are dealing each other, how they are meeting each other. That she is thinking that. And Krishna is thinking that they must be thinking that I am with these girls. So to pacify, who will tolerate your beloved will love somebody else other than you? How can you tolerate it? How can I take it? So to pacify, Krishna is sending a message with a messenger. This is the thing going on, event. So Radharani is in totally mad state, unmad sthiti. She is very angry, kopamana. In that state, so he is going to speak something. So here it is saying that this Madhukara, why Krishna sent that Madhukara, that messenger? Na prastapaitam, to pacify. To pacify Radharani. So to see that pacifying messenger and the message, hearing something about that, so she is speaking. In this matter, it is totally in the mood of Radharani. She is in her dhyana, Krishna Sangama dhyana. So in that stage she is speaking. So that jalpa vakya, if we people want to understand in our consciousness, then first of all, we have to take out our attachment from this material world. There are 9 things which attract us forcibly and attached to the material world. Sabda, sparsa, rupa, rasa, gandha, these 5 are there. Objects. Sukha, dukha, siddhi and sakti. These are 4. So 4 and plus 5, there are 9 things. These 9 things forcibly attract our mind towards material things, to the material world. We can think of it. Sabda, sparsa, rupa, rasa, gandha. Sukha, dukha, siddhi and sakti. These are 9 things. So we have to first, if you really try to understand, go into it, then you have these 9 things where our mind is dwelling most of the time. We have to bring our mind from these 9 things from this world. And then what to do? Now download Radha Bhav in your mind and heart. What she is thinking, what's her relation, what her stage, what her consciousness. Then we can enter into this talk. Because here it is in, she is speaking in kalpaitva, it is word comes, in kalpana, imagination, total imagination. Whatever she is speaking, it's a kalpana, it's imagination only. But the acharyas, they are selling, that is the Veda Vidya, that is the essence the sum total essence of all Vedic knowledge. Vedis sarvai ahameva vidyah. Krishna himself told that among all Vedic literatures, I am to be known. And who knows Radharani? No, who knows Krishna fully? Who knows Krishna? Krishna is the object of loving, object lovable. Then he loves Krishna. And nobody can match the love of Krishna with Radharani. Supermost. So she knows. Again, in 15th chapter, Krishna told, Yo mameva asammudho janati purushottamam. Those who are not mudha, they are asammudha, then they are vidwan. Mudha means murkha, sammudha means murkha, asammudha means they are not really murkha, they are vidwan. Asammudha janati purushottamam. If he knows me, that I am the uttama purusha, I am the purusha, the supreme personality of Godhead. Janati purushottamam. Just by knowing that I am the supreme purusha, purushottama, just by knowing that, he will become all knower. Sa sarvavit. He will be all knower. Then he doesn't have to know anything else. Just by knowing Krishna as the Supreme Purusha, you know everything. Sa sarvabhit. This Krishna is saying. Yes, he will become sarvabhit. Because Krishna is everything. Everything is manifestation of his energy. Internal, external, marginal, whatever, it is his only. So to know him, to know everything. Sa sarvabhit. So now question will arise, if somebody becomes sarvabhit, then he has to do something or doing nothing? What will happen to him? If somebody know you as a uttama purusha, the supreme purusha, he will become all-knower. After becoming all-knower, then what will do? What will happen to him after becoming all-knower? Then Krishna is saying he has to do only one thing. Nothing else. Now what that? Now bhajate mam. Sa sarvavid bhajate mam. He will do my bhajan only. So those who are doing exclusively Krishna bhajan, they are all knower. Sa sarvavid bhajate mam. How they are doing bhajan just like we are doing? No, 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 no. Sarva bhavena bharat, O bharat, he will do bhava bhakti. Not this kind of bhakti. In bhava. Then mahabhava will come. In bhava, we know that sakhya, vachalya, madhurya, one more? Dasya. Dasya, sakhya, vachalya and madhurya. These four are bhava, chaturbhava, chari bhava bhakti. Among these four, in one relation, they relate with me in one of these four and they will perform bhajan. That's called sarva bhavena. Any of these four, they will accept and they will do bhajan. Bhavena bhava, bhava bhakti they will do. So this type of bhava bhakti will arouse love of Krishna in your heart. Krishna rati. And that rati will become gadha. More and more and more, finally, that rati will become so intense, then it will convert into prema. And then you take up prema, then mana, pranaya, kopa, raga, anuraga, all these things, till bhav. Then mahabhava and all that. So, so long to go. But those who have achieved in that state, they are already in that state. It is not something like that we are associating with the devotees. we are seeing that it is in Vrindavan, so we are remembering Radha Krishna, we are reading now Bhagavatam. So no, for Radharani there should not be any nimitta, any reason. No reason. Nitya, not even a fraction of second when he is bereft of Krishna, away from Krishna. No, nitya. Other things not required. He's always immersed with Krishna's thinking. And thinking of Krishna, Krishna Sangamam. Then just think about how and where there is a question of Nirguna Nirakara. If Brahma, Param Brahma is Nirguna Nirakara, he has to be Saguna Sakar now here. It has to be. Here dhyana. Sangama dhyana. Dhyana sangama. That is Radharani's position. So she is going to speak and speaking out of her imagination. What is she is imagining? She is imagining that Krishna loving dealings with Mathura Nagari, that is city girls of Mathura, they are loving exchanges, their dealings. And I am suffering here thinking of that only. And because I am now angry, to pacify me, Krishna sent a messenger. So, and he, that messenger is now trying to pacify through some medium of yoga, this, that he is speaking. So that's why Radharani is saying, you are speaking only garbage. You are holding the honey, but you are not putting in your mouth. You are only madhu kara. Kara means hand. You are holding the madhu in your hand only. First you taste it. Then you speak, at least some sweetness will come from your words. There is no sweet words from your mouth. Only bitter words are coming. Holding madhu, what is the use of that? You eat it. Because Uddhava does not know that this is madhu, this is sweet. That's why Krishna, this Radharani is now making Uddhava to taste. Uddhava was considering himself, he was the supreme learned person in the universe. Now he is getting the teachings, the learnings from this illiterate girl, those who have never seen school and college in their life till now. Because from the beginning of their life, they know only how to love Krishna, nothing else. Whatever they are dealing and speaking, center around loving Krishna. So love of Krishna, love of Godhead, is such things, no need of any material education to get that. It needs detachment and practice. That's why I told these nine things, which forcibly taking our mind from us to this material object, we should bring it back. Bringing it back, then download the bhava of Radharani, the consciousness of Radharani into our antakarana. It is not that possible, not at all possible, but still we have no other hope, no scope. Those who are in that stage, they can enter into that mood. So they are saying that Radharani, in that state of consciousness, that state of thinking, kalpayitva prasthapitang dutang, that messenger, and he is imagining, she is imagining, because at that time Madhukara, Krishna came, I told you, somebody said Krishna came as bumblebee. He is there already. What is name? Uddhava is sitting there. He is stuck in Uddhava, then one bumblebee came and he was trying to touch the feet of Radharani. Radharani saw that, oh, acha, you are so expert. Exactly like your master. You know. Then Radharani imagining that whatever that bumblebee is doing, by looking at bumblebee and speaking of thinking of Krishna, that speaking is called Dibya Unmada Vakya. Out of transcendental madness. Suppose we become mad. Sometimes we become mad also. Many times we are mad. When we become mad, we speak to the pillar, we speak to the tree, we speak to any object. At that time, we never think that that thing, that person, or that object to whom we are speaking, he is receiving, he is understanding, he is hearing or not. We don't have any knowledge of it. We are just speaking and imagining, yes, he or she is hearing. And he is doing like that, he is hearing, he is understanding everything. That is called imagination. So Sri Radhika's imagination, maybe for us imagination, but that is 100% fact. All the Vedic scriptures said, Purna Satya, Purna Satya. That Parma Satya, he became a bumblebee in front of and coming to the lotus feet of Radharani. In front of Radha Prem. Krishna himself in the form of bumblebee has to test the abusing words, the Bharsana Vakya. And this 10 texts, 10 shlokas of Bharsana, Jalpa Vakya, out of madness. I told madness means when you speak to somebody and we don't know whether he is understanding or he is understanding, she is able to understand, she is a material object or she is a subject, is a person or in person, whatever, we don't know. We are speaking out of our imagination. So Radharani was in that state. So much completely absorbed in trance of Krishna Sangama, oneness with Krishna, that Krishna is already within Radha and Radha is within the Krishna, in that trance. And when she is feeling that mana, kopa, and out of that, the speaking, that the whatever she is speaking, that is the truth of all Vedic scripture. So that imagining talkings with Bhramara, in the whole Bhagavatam, these 10 shlokas are called Bhramara Gitam. All 10 are one kind of Jalpa Vakya. That's the whole 10 are called Chitra Jalpa. So from tomorrow onwards, you will hear that. Very, very intense, feelingful, what Radharani is going to speak, is speaking now. She is speaking, she is looking at that bumblebee. Whatever that bumblebee is doing, she is thinking that exactly I am thinking to that bee, and she is reciprocating exactly. But exactly the reciprocation going between Radha and Krishna. For us, it is Dibya Unmadish madness. How come she is speaking like that? Even for Uddhava, others, it's not that easy to enter into that realm. So, unless and until we are in that stage or that consciousness, how can we trace into it? So, for us, it will be only imagination, kalpana vakya. So, how Srimati Radharani finally, that's why it's Kachit Gopi, Drishtva Madhukaram. So, this in Mahabhava stage, राधिनीरे सार है भाव, भावेर सार है महाभाव, श्री राधे रानी महाभाव स्वरूपिणी राधा ठाकुरानी। इट इज सेड श्री राधिका इज गोविंद नंदिनी गोविंद सर्वस्व। इन एलोन श्रीमती राधारानी एवरीथिंग दैट इज टू बी देयर फॉर कृष्णस प्लीजर, एवरीथिंग इज देयर विद इन हर ओनली, एवरीथिंग दैट रिक्वायर्ड, दैट्स वेल देवी कृष्णमयी, सी इज दैट। सो व्हेन सी इज स्पीकिंग इन हर दिव्य उन्माद स्थिति, so that's why, and Krishna knows that these things will come, that's why Krishna was so much interested to hear that one syllable, one words. She came all the way from Mathura, even if he sent Uddhava with letter, but he came all the way from Mathura as a bumblebee and touching the feet of Radharani and wants to hear all this sentence of madness from Radharani. Dibya Unmad Vakya, that Jalp Vakya. And each sentence is different varieties of Jalpana. Different times of Jalpana. Each and every text, every sentence, a different kind of Jalpana. So only that Krishna Madhupa, he can only taste that Madhu. Actually, Madhukara and Madhu bees are different. Madhupa, those are bumblebee, they can drink the madhus, but they cannot create Madhu. Madhu, the honey is created by honeybee. This bumblebee, they are not creator of honey, they only eater of honey. These things, Radharani, all will speak that you are like that. So, because it is already there in the Bhagavatam, so slowly those who are reading through from first canto, step by step, so they can come to this stage and they can accept and understand who Krishna is, who Radharani is, how they are feeling and dealing, how their behavior. So it is so sweet, it is so transcendental. So we have no words to express, sort of words. So anyway, I just gave the introduction that the Chitra Jalpa, the coming 10 texts are the supermost supreme sentence spoken by Srimati Radharani in her supreme conscious stage, in her Viraha Sthiti, in her Mahabhava Sthiti, Dibya Unmada Sthiti. So from tomorrow onwards you will enjoy, hear it. Sri Sri Radha Sam Sundar Ki Jai.
When one's in grade school, when we're studying arithmetic like algebra, geometry, trigonometry, advanced mathematics, what can a grade school person advantage by hearing or trying to understand these advanced mathematical understandings?
Just like we are speaking to a stone, nothing. Just like we are speaking to a stone, so these topics will be those who are PhD in that topic, trigonometry, algebra, they will accept this. What is this? That's why it's a kalpana, imagination, will make a myth. For them it is nothing.
we're all in grade school, so how are we ultimately benefiting by hearing about trigonometry and geometry and advanced levels, maybe beyond our capacity to understand?
Both things are different to it. that is taking on that way, this is taking on that way. So that's why this Divya Unmada starts from zero, from illiterate stage. In Braj, not a single boy or girl, they went to school. Nothing they know except love. Their education starts from love only. Everything they subject from love only. So they are in that stage. And we are going in material education. So material education is taking us away and away and away. Yes, yes, I can.
Just saying, our level of Krishna consciousness is ABC, but that level of Krishna consciousness is way, way higher.
Yes, yes.
What is
yes.
our benefit to hearing the way, way
higher? Oh.
That is an example.
Yeah, thank you. Hare Krishna. Yes.
Hare Krishna Maharaj, thank you very much for the wonderful explanation. Maharaj, can you explain in our level, as you said, that first we have to have
developed
the detachment
yes.
through nine various
yes.
processes. So, can you explain this?
I told already that we are fully absorbed in whatever sukh. We want to get happiness, and we have to get happiness through these five things: sadda, sasparsa, rupa, rasa, gandha, and sukh, dukh, siddhi, and sakti. These are the nine things. Where we are always 24/7 we are there. So we have to get out from there. That's why we are considering ourselves as this body. This is all detail, Gita, Bhagavata, understand. Then we will understand we are not this body, our soul, and this business of soul. And then slowly, 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 slowly go to that stage. So we can just see that this that's all so long we have to go. But never ever think to get away from the road. If you go on walking, someday you will understand it. Okay? So to keep on going, keep on going. Yes.
Thank you, Maharaj, for the nice class. One question I had about the incognito name of Sri Radharani, which is not revealed in the Srimad Bhagavatam. We also find the famous verse in the
Aradhana.
So the question that comes to my mind is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, without any qualification, he gave Krishna Prem. Yadi Gaurna Vaito, Tabiki Vaito, Kemone Dharita, Radhara Mahima. Prema Rasa Shiva Jagata Janata gave.
Yes.
So, without any qualification he gave
yeah.
this Vraj Prem,
yeah.
Then how come Srimad Bhagavatam has kept it a secret?
No. The Supreme Lord, he has that power he can give. Nothing else, none else. See, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that's why no other Swansa avatar. They can't give that frame. Only Sivan Mahaprabhu has to come to give that test. Any other avataras, no?
But Srimad Bhagavatam is Krishna.
Hmm?
Srimad Bhagavatam is Krishna.
Srimad Bhagavatam.
Sri Goswami says.
Yes.
He is Krishna.
Srimad Bhagavatam, if you understand Bhagavatam, you have to follow the footsteps of Sivan Mahaprabhu. Otherwise, you are not getting the real Bhagavatam. भागवत पढ़ गया भागवत स्थाने एकांत आश्रय कर चैतन्य चरणे धीनोंडी ओके यस Yes.
So how to take these, and especially my question is, like sometimes we hear that one of the five rasas, we should meditate on one. So how to meditate on our, so should we more focus on improving our sadhana, and at the same time, should we choose one of the rasas that we can relate to Krishna, or we should just focus on?
Just focus your sadhana. By hearing this kind of pastimes, you will be really assured, fully assured, oh, this thing is there. I am going to reach to that state. Then you will become too much asavadi. Yes, yes, yes. Then I have to do to my optimum capacity, because these things are there. Okay? That will pursue your hopes. Asavadi. Asabandha samatkantha namagane sadaruchi. That is our hope. Okay. Yes.
You gave this nine things which are conditioned souls get attracted towards the material world. The last two are Shakti and Siddhi.
Siddhi, yes.
Can you please tell the difference between the two?
Shakti is your power and Siddhi is perfection. Okay.
Wouldn't Siddhi be as good as power, Maharaj?
But yes, it's kind of power, but not just like we have some power to do physical power. And Siddhi means if you have that Siddhi, then even in this limited power you can do unlimited things. That is called Siddhi. Isita, Kama Vasaita, this is called Siddhi. We want to do, oh, I don't have power. If I could have that perfection, that Siddhi, I could have definitely do that. That is called Siddhi. So that's our expectation is to get some of Siddhis to enjoy. Isn't it? Yes. Okay. Grandhra Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran ki jai.
Is only Bhakti Atri Vaishnava Maharaj ki jai.